for 2015. It's going to be a good one. A top five matchup for our Class 4A state championship. The number two ranked Stevenson Patriots and Jalen Brunson look for the final piece of the puzzle against the unknown, the normal community Ironmen, and Iron Nation is out in droves for this one. And welcome into our broadcast, our Class 4A state championship. I'm Matt Littlewald here, courtside here at Carver Arena. So glad you're with us this evening for the final game of the year. Stevenson and Normal, kind of the unknown. Not sure how this one's going to go, but Normal's chopped down some big-time trees to get here, and they are fearless and should be fearless tonight as they go up against Jalen Brunson, Connor Cashaw, two best friends searching for one prize that's eluded them for the last 4 years. Will they get it tonight? Will they make history? 20 years of March Madness here in Peoria? You never know. Let's send it over tableside as we get set for our Class 4A state championship. And welcome in Dave Bernhardt and Cameron Smith. Gentlemen.
Thank you very much, man. And we cannot wait to get this started. In fact, these teams have been building to this moment. Stevenson, they expected to get here. Normal, they got that big win over Simeon earlier this week. And I don't know what their exact mottos are, but many times, Cameron, you see teams, their motto is just flat out finish. And I think that is really appropriate here tonight.
Well, you're right about that, Dave. Both teams have the goal of winning that 4A state title, but they have different motivations. For Normal, they're trying to prove to everyone that they belong here on this stage for this championship game. And for Stevenson, this is their third trip down to Peoria. They lost in their first trip in that championship game against Simeon, came up short in the semifinal last year against Whitney Young. This is their moment. This is what they believe. Let's see if they can capture that championship trophy.
And that common denominator, he wears number 15 for Stevenson. That's Jalen Brunson.
Well, Jalen Brunson, this is his last chance to cement his legacy in Illinois as a member of that elite group of superstars. Now, he's mature enough to understand the balance of achieving his individual goals with his team goals. The McDonald's All-American believes it's his turn to sit on the throne. And for Normal, Alex Peacock, he came up huge for his team with a go-ahead tip-in in last night's semifinal win. He's very versatile on the offensive end with this game, and he makes it difficult to guard.
Normal community. Huge crowd here today in Carver Arena. On the other side, Stevenson. They brought everybody from Lincolnshire. They're going to get it on, and we're going to get it on next. Stevenson and Normal Community, your 4A title. Welcome back to Carver Arena here in Peoria, moments away from tip-off. Teams fight to get to this very spot. First of all, for Stevenson, this is how they got here. A 20-point win last night over Bolingbrook. They forced 21 turnovers in that ball game. On the other side, Normal Community. It was a 2-point win over Geneva last night and an eye-popping 64-50 win in the Super Sectionals over Simeon, the top-ranked team in the state at that time. Let's go to Paul Herzog, our public address announcer at Carver Arena.
Good evening, basketball fans. On behalf of the Illinois High School Association of the City of Peoria, welcome to Carver Arena for America's original March Madness, and this is 108th year of state series competition. Tonight's 4A championship game for 2015 features the Stevenson Patriots from Lincolnshire, a record of 29-3, and Normal Community Ironmen, 33-1. And now to honor America, please remove your caps and stand and pause for a moment of silence as we remember the men and women of the armed forces serving us here and around the world, away from their families, protecting our freedom. Thank you, as we thank them. And now to help commemorate the 20th year of America's original March Madness in Peoria, the IHSA is pleased to welcome a special guest national anthem soloist. As a national anthem singer for the Chicago Blackhawks, Jim Cornelison is known for a raucous rendition of the anthem that works United fans to a fever pitch, leaving them no choice but to cheer along. Carver Arena fans, please provide a warm March Madness greeting to Jim Cornelison, and to celebrate America, don't stop cheering until the rendition is done. Jim Cornelison.
Oh, say can you see? Streaming, and the rockets red glare
us meet the starting lineups for this 4A championship game. For Lincolnshire, Stevenson at a guard, a 6'5 senior, one, Connor Cashaw. And a guard for Normal Community, a 6-foot senior, 10, Tyler Vance. And a guard for the Patriots, a 6-foot senior, 12, Matthew Johnson. And a guard for the Ironmen, a 6-1 senior, 11, David Boyd. The third guard for Stevenson, a 6-2 senior, 15, Jalen Brunson. The third guard for Normal Community, a 6-5 senior, 21, Zach Thompson. And a forward for the Patriots, a 6-7 sophomore, 3, Justin Smith. At center for the Ironmen, a 6-7 senior, 33, Tyler Sebring. And a forward for Stevenson, a 6-5 senior, 5, Parker Nichols. And at forward for Normal Community, a 6-7 senior, 23, Alex Peacock. Head coach for Stevenson, 16 years, a record of 331 and 137, Pat Ambrose.
Our officials for tonight's championship ball game, Jukia Sam Moran and Tom Fuller. And they enjoyed that anthem as much as you did. Our ball presenter for this state championship ball game, the penultimate game here, is Brad Halverson from Caterpillar, and he is very instrumental, of course, in bringing this state tournament back to Peoria for the next 5 years. Let's check in with Kelly Crowell.
Thanks, Dave. This is it for senior Jalen Brunson, the last game of his high school career, and he wants nothing more than to add that state championship to his already decorated resume. It's really the only award missing for the McDonald's All-American. Now, just moments ago, his Villanova Wildcats fell to NC State in the NCAA tournament. Now, he was out here warming up, so I don't know if he knows the final results of what just happened, but if he does, you know that's only going to fuel the fire tonight. He's already said that he is ready to bring home the hardware for the Patriots. Let's get this game done, guys.
Well, we have to wait just a bit so the hair on my neck settles back down. This is absolutely an unbelievable atmosphere.
Well, listening to these two student sections, you see Stevenson up top, they're decked out in all black, and for Normal, they're decked out in all orange, so they are ready, these players are ready, the fans are ready. I know we are ready. Let's get this thing going.
Yeah, get him out of the huddle. Let's go. Let's throw this ball up. There is Carver Arena. There is the Stevenson section. It was huge last night, and it was white. They are ready to roll.
This is what high school basketball is all about. The passion in the stands and the competitive nature on the court.
It will be Justin Smith going up against Alex Peacock. And our 4A title game is underway.
Come out in the man-to-man, sag that defense a little bit, and they're not going to extend until they are guarding someone with the ball on the perimeter. That's a nice pass from Nichols over to the young pup, Justin Smith, to crack this game open.
Man-to-man the other way for the Patriots. David Boyd with the ball.
Stevenson loves that man-to-man pressure on the ball that allows them to ignite themselves and create a lot of opportunities in transition. Let's see if they can turn over the Iron Man in this game.
Right out of the box, Tyler Vance with the miss. Bodies on the floor, Stevenson. Let's play a little more. Nope, they're going to get the ball back. Here's our first possession.
Well, normally you have jitters in a game like this, but with Stevenson, they've been on this stage before. Good job moving that basketball around. Nichols over to Smith for the easy layup. They do a great job of just finding each other around the arc and inside of the lane.
Smith in and out for the sophomore. This is a starting lineup for these two teams combined. Nine seniors on the floor. Smith, the only underclassman.
That means it's a lot of experience out here. A lot of guys that have been through a ton of battles on the floor. So they know what it takes to get the job done.
Open from the corner, leaving it short is Zach Thompson. Brunson with numbers against him.
Well, let's go to the keys for Normal Community. They have to be window wipers. The rebounding battle is an area that Normal must control in order to win this game. And the next key, keep it ugly. Dave Witzig knows that his team is more successful in grinded out type games. They must keep the play in the half court and be physical on the defensive end.
Brunson creates his own space.
That's filthy. That is filthy. We saw him go through his struggles yesterday in the semifinals, and he had 21 points. A lot of that was from the free throw line, but that's a great sign for Jalen Brunson and Stevenson to see him with the step back jumper and knocking down that three.
They stop Peacock. Thompson swings the left side. Sebring can shoot it. Tyler Sebring with the three.
How about the star player stepping up early on? Tyler Sebring is going to play his basketball at Elon next season, and they are getting a dynamic player.
Boyd will take it out of there.
Interesting matchup with Sebring and Parker Nichols. Parker Nichols is a stalwart on the defensive end, takes a ton of charges for his Patriots team. And for the Patriots tonight, they have to control the tempo. Their guards must keep the pace at a high level. They scored 23 points off turnovers and 12 points on the break in yesterday's win. And finally, they have to own the moment, Dave. These seniors remember falling short of their state championship goals in the previous 2 years. This is a moment they've waited for all season long. It's time for them to step up.
They have the early two-point lead. David Boyd, quick feet. Will not go for Peacock. Hunter Cashaw wants to run. You may have heard Pat Ambrose say, let's go, let's go. Cashaw. Once again, a rebound to Sebring.
We don't mind that shot from Connor Cashaw. That was good movement between himself and Justin Smith working in a two-man game. But getting back to my point, Dave, Stevenson trying to push the tempo of this game. They must control it if they're going to try and get a win. And you better believe in this state championship game, the superstars are going to shine bright. Jalen Brunson, a little step back. Come back here, Tyler Vance. Let me dot your eye with this three. And Tyler Sebring says, hey, I got my brothers back. I'm going to come up and knock down this three.
For your auto, home, life, business, and retirement needs, call the Country Financial Representative near you at 1-866-COUNTRY or visit us at countryfinancial.com. One of these things is not like the other.
He sees himself on that scoreboard, so he's going to go nuts right now. A little wiggle for the Teletubby in there. That's a smart decision. Go with the yellow in the all-black student section.
And not to be outdone, a half-hour trip from Normal to Peoria has resulted in a huge crowd for the Ironmen.
Well, I'll follow the Ironmen Twitter account, and they were encouraging fans to, hey, if you haven't signed up for that student bus, do it before we leave, because we need everybody down in Peoria to support our team.
They're looking for the tie on this trip. Boyd creates and gets it. David Boyd.
That's a sneaky move from David Boyd. We saw how important he was in yesterday's semifinal, coming up with big steals and big buckets for the Ironmen just to keep them in striking distance.
How about his line yesterday? 5 points, 9 rebounds, 3 assists, and 4 steals.
Well, that's a total floor game. And speaking of total floor game, Connor Cashaw didn't get that to go, but his activity on the glass. But David Boyd is an unsung hero for Normal Community.
Cashaw gets his hands in there. Cashaw. For the lead.
Well, this young man on the defensive end of the court is outstanding. 6 steals in yesterday's semifinal, and he's going to get himself going early. He does a great job of getting his hands in the passing lane, causing deflections and getting steals. And once he gets that ball, he's off to the races. You're not going to beat him up the floor. I like this matchup between Cashaw and Peacock. They are battling on that block. Not going to try and give each other an inch. Nice move.
Peacock wins that battle. His first points of the night, coming off a 16-point effort last night.
And that's something we're going to have to look at throughout this evening. Cashaw and Peacock battling each other.
Brunson able to draw the foul.
Well, Peacock, the Peacock-Cashaw battle will live on throughout this night. But Peacock doing a good job of being patient. Good job of just whipping that left leg around to create space and push Cashaw back. Not an offensive foul. That's just a great aggressive spin move to get a layup.
Jalen Brunson at the line in the semifinal last night. 13 of 14 from the free throw line.
It's a player that knows how to get his baskets, whether it's from the three, from the free throw line, inside of the paint. When that game opens up for him, you better watch out. Because not only can he score, but he can get his teammates involved. He's holds so many records in the history of Stevenson basketball.
Dwayne Farrington along with Mason Meyer in the game for Normal Community.
With the pressure defense from the Patriots. Cashaw with a little slippage on that end, but it gets back up and comes back. But defensively for Stevenson, they are a very disciplined team, helping the helper, and that's a good block from Jalen Brunson on the rotation. Again, right to my point, they do a great job of having each other's back. If one person gets beat, the other teammate comes over and shuts off any looks offensively for their opponent.
Justin Smith with the miss. Boyd on the push. Meyer. And we're tied again.
That's a good job from Meyer taking the opportunity in front of him. You have to make sure that when those chances come, you are aggressive and you're confident.
Matt Johnson open. And that's going to be 3 free throws coming up. Alex Peacock got the ball and then continued on and got Johnson.
A lot of coaches teach closing out. And during my days at SIU under Chris Lowry, we did a drill where we just closed out with our hands straight up, chopping our feet. But there's Jalen Brunson, nice pass. And when you don't close out and chop your feet and just try and go for the block, that happens. You end up fouling a 3-point shooter. And Matt Johnson is very efficient at the free throw line, can knock him down with the best of them.
77% from the line for the 6-foot senior.
Talked about how great Brunson is as a scorer, but he's a great distributor of the basketball. He knows that when the eyes are on him, there's a teammate open, and he found Johnson at that moment. But again, Dave, back in those SIU days, every time before practice, we'll go the entire court. We'll close out to the free throw line, close out to the half court with our high hands straight up. And if you didn't have your hands up, you have to start all over again. Chris Lowry was not happy. He's at Kansas State now, coaching with Bruce Weber over there in the Big 12, but he was very, very adamant about having us close out with our hands straight up. Even if our opponent caught the ball at half court, he still wanted us to chop our feet and close out, just because when you do that on shooters, you're already disciplined and you know what to do so you don't foul a 3-point shooter.
Pat Ambrose in his 16th season, 331 wins for Ambrose, second in 2013, third last year. 2 out of 3 for Johnson. And he'll be replaced by Ruji Aoki.
I love this young man's game. Ruji Aoki is a spark plug off the bench for Pat Ambrose. Knockdown shooter, and he has a little wiggle in his game. So you try and guard up and try and pressure him, he has some handle and can get past you.
Farrington working on Smith.
That's good on-ball pressure from Justin Smith. He's close to a 5 count.
Farrington goes all the way, blocked by Cashaw.
Normal, they have to stop the basketball in transition. It's a good job from them getting back and recognizing where the ball is.
To the top, Nichols holds for Brunson. Nichols going to launch a 3. Lincolnshire. Smith to Brunson for two.
That's a nice pass from Justin Smith. He knew that he wasn't going to be in the area to finish that play. Knew that Brunson was behind him. Gave him a good pass, and Brunson finishing that over Tyler Seaborn. Dave, we know that basketball is a game of runs, so now for Normal, can you respond to this opening blow by Stevenson?
Four straight points scored by the Patriots. The miss from Sebring. Brunson will attack.
Whoa. That is why he is a McDonald's All-American. The ability to break down his defender and finish in traffic. Villanova, you are getting a star. Look at him, in and out move with the right, and then comes in through the trees, contact and one. Just an amazing player. When he has that ball and he's coming at you full steam ahead, you're in no man's land because he has so many moves that he can go to right or left that puts you in a bind.
And Brunson with 10 first quarter points. Seven straight points scored by Stevenson.
This onslaught has been powerful from the Patriots. Couldn't ask for a better start for Pat Ambrose's crew in this state championship.
They will get Vance on the foul of Brunson after the steal.
I mean, he's everywhere, Dave. On the offensive end, he's getting it done. Defensively, he's in the passing lanes, getting steals, causing another foul on Tyler Vance. So we're going to see David Boyd come back into this game for Vance. Just the activity from Jalen Brunson. You want your leader to set the tone. And that's exactly what Jalen is doing in this opening quarter of play.
Now shuttling in and off the bench, Connor Altman will come in replacing Vance. Replacing Sebring.
I like this move from Coach Witzig. He's going to get Vance. He's going to get Sebring out. Don't want those guys to pick up any cheap fouls. Get it. The responsibility falls on these reserves. They have to make sure that they close out this quarter on a positive note. A defensive stop would be huge for the Ironmen's confidence.
Vance picked up his second foul on that last play. They've opened the floor for Brunson. Patient, taking his time, gets it off in time, will not go. But a 7-0 run by the Patriots have given them a 7-point lead at the half. Jalen Brunson, quiet last night in semis. Anything but that here tonight. And one for a 7-point lead. A 16-9 lead for Stevenson. And yes, you are indeed on TV. You and Jalen Brunson are McDonald's player profile tonight. Jalen Brunson, not only is our McDonald's player profile, he will be profiled big time when he plays in the McDonald's All-American game coming up here in a few weeks. In fact, that he will be coached by the head coach from Simeon High School. That is Robert Smith. So our player profile tonight, 23 points on the season, 10 in the first quarter here tonight.
I'm sure Robert Smith and Jalen will share a couple of laughs and talk about a few games that they've competed in against each other. Coach Smith on the sidelines and Jalen on the floor. But what an outstanding honor to be selected as a McDonald's All-American. That is the elite of the elite. Jalen will showcase his skills for one more time, his final time on the prep scene at the United Center in April.
Tough to get the ball inbounds. Boyd will lose it. Let's check in with Kelly Kroll.
Well, guys, Coach Dave Witzig for Normal is probably not going to be very happy with that last time down the floor. The last thing he said to his guys was be strong with the basketball on the other end. He said we turned it over three times in that first quarter. They scored 4 points off of that. If you take that away, it's a 12-9 game. He felt like his team still played, you know, didn't play so well, but they were still in this. As Jalen Brunson scores again, he said, guys, we just have to stay true to the course, take care of the basketball. So let's look for that this time around.
Well, there you go, Kelly. A turnover leads to two on the other end.
And that is the area for Stevenson to thrive in. If they can turn over Normal and more specifically live ball turnovers where they can get out in transition and get things going. And Silas Sebring, that's just a man move right there. Pure strength. Getting to that bucket, the Elon signee. But speaking of a man move, this is big paws on a small pup. The sophomore, Justin Smith, athleticism, scooping that layup off of the glass. And a lot of people feel that he is the next guy in line for this Stevenson basketball program. He has everything, the size, the skill set, the athleticism. He just needs to put all of it together, gain a little more confidence, and he'll be fine next year as a junior.
Sebring's three-point play ends a 9-0 Stevenson run.
The Patriots offensively, five white jerseys. They do more of a four-out, one-in motion offense, trying to look for the dribble drives with Brunson and Cashaw and Justin Smith with the ball on in their hands.
A three-ball from Brunson.
I mean, it's danger time for the Ironman. It is danger time because he is in a groove right now. The surgeon is performing a surgical procedure on the defense.
21-12. Blocking foul on the way there, but on the other end, Jalen Brunson getting it done.
I mean, when he gets into this groove, you cannot do anything. Now, right now, he's just playing his favorite song. Now, he has his playlist on shuffle. He has his song on, and he's just in a groove, knocking down that three-point shot, recognizing the defense. You give him that space and that inch, he's going to take it. Great player like that, you can't give him any room or any looks at the rim.
Nearly a steal by Smith. Stevenson recovers so quickly defensively.
It's all reaction time for the Patriots with the closeouts and beating normal to the spots. Good pass from Sebring.
Results in three from Zach Thompson.
That is a Division I next level pass from Sebring, finding Thompson. Thompson had his struggles in yesterday's semifinal. That's good for him and his confidence to knock down that three.
He is feeling it.
Wow.
Jalen Brunson knocks another one down.
And he already knows. I see him talking right now. He said, these guys can't guard me. And a lot of people feel that that's cockiness. That's just confidence on his part because he understands that he can get anywhere that he wants with that basketball.
Farrington inside will score his first point of the night for the 6'2 senior.
Nice floating jumper from Dwayne Farrington. And right now, Normal is answering the call against Stevenson. They had their moments in that first quarter where they weren't able to respond to the big blows from the Patriots, but now they are comfortable in this game, and they're getting the looks that they want.
Smith in and out.
It's a small win for Coach Whitzik's team. Now they have to capitalize. They get the stop on one end. Now they have to come back and score. Nice move.
Sebring, oh my goodness, nearly made it go.
It was a beautiful move, but it would have been even greater if he made that layup.
Here comes Boyd. Thompson goes baseline.
The Normal community is trying to play Stevenson's game, and that's an up and down pace. That's not normal for Dave Whitzik's team. They're more of a half court, grind it out, play you physical type of team. They're just trying to match the speed and talent of the Patriots.
Peacock hasn't had many touches tonight.
Jalen Brunson owning the moment in this first half. The surgeon stepping back, knocking it down, coming over on the defensive end. The leader setting the tone, and that's an and-one, ladies and gentlemen. Jalen Brunson is real.
Him in from miles around for our state championship matchup here in Class 4A. Stevenson with the 6-point lead midway through the second quarter. Matt Riddlewald with you here courtside at Carver Arena. Coming up here at the break, we'll take a look at stats, go through some highlights on how we got to this point. We'll also have third and fourth place trophies with Bolingbrook and Geneva receiving their very first trophies in boys basketball. That's all coming up the break. I'll send it back over to Dave and Cameron, guys.
Thanks, Matt. 3:58 to play here in the first half. Jalen Brunson with 15 points. Got a couple of threes. 3 for 3 from the line. But it'll be Alex Peacock shooting 2 here.
Jalen is matching his jersey number with his points, and Peacock missing that first one. But this is a young man that has to get his game going. Member of the All-State team, second team All-State. But he is a superstar, and you have to have your superstar step up in these moments as he misses both free throws, and that is very uncharacteristic of Alex Peacock.
He had 25 points in the super sectional win over Simeon, and his team rode his back. He scored 18 of his team's first 22 points in that game.
Well, on the offensive end for Normal, they're shooting very well, 46% from the field and 50% from three, but they just have to slow down Brunson on the defensive end. It's only a 6-point ball game, as great as Jalen Brunson has been. So Normal is still within striking distance, so that's a small victory for them. Keep the score close. Don't let things get out of hand, and you'll strike when the timing is right.
Back to the top in Cashaw, guarded by Peacock. Now Johnson.
Work their offense with a motion, down screens, back screens. Just kind of run some time off the clock. But what's going to happen now is they're going to set this ball screen for Brunson and allow him to operate off the pick.
There it is. And that one got away a little bit. That's the first turnover of the game for Stevenson. It comes with 2:51 to play in the first half.
This is a rare moment where you will see Jalen Brunson on the opposite page of one of his teammates. We're a little too high for Justin Smith. I'm sure they can connect on it again as this game goes forward. But again, it's another stop for Normal Community on the defensive end. Let's see if they can come back and answer with the score. It's all about shutouts and scores in the game of basketball.
Travel call, an unfortunate one for Zach Thompson.
Thompson just losing his footing on that turnover. For the second look at it, as his feet just leave from underneath him. That left foot slipping. And that's going to be another turnover for Normal Community.
So that's two straight possessions. Normal has been unable to take advantage of their defensive stops.
And Dave, that's so important, because in the championship game, as Johnson's going to turn that ball right back over, sliding that foot. But again, it's so important of taking your opportunities. When you're turning a team over, you have to make sure, or you're getting defensive stops, you have to make sure that you're getting points off of those stops or those turnovers, because it will prove key as the game goes along.
6-point difference.
Look at Connor Cashaw. I mean, he is so active. He's not battling arm in arm with Peacock. He's moving his feet.
And that turnover will lead to a couple of free throws here for Brunson. LSA is fouled on the floor, so no free throws for Brunson. His team leads it 23-17.
Houston trying to get close to that bonus before this half is over. 5 team fouls on each team. These are two really good free throw shooting teams too, Dave. So if this game goes down to the wire, I expect these players to step up and knock them down.
Even some fans thought Cashaw picked up some contact the other way. Peacock, there's contact there, and an offensive foul on Alex Peacock.
Well, that's a great call from the official. It took him a little time to make that call because he had to get his whistle back in his mouth after running down the court. As you see Parker Nichols, now he can make a full video on how to take charges. I mean, this young man is the all-time charge leader in Stevenson basketball history. I'm just going to go out there and say that he averages at least 4 to 5 charges a game, because he knows where to be, he sets his feet, and he takes the contact, and that's so important for Parker Nichols with these charges.
And Nichols will send Peacock to the bench with 2 fouls. Tyler Vance, 2 fouls as well for the Ironmen from Normal Community.
That is huge for their attack. Now Coach Witzig has to go to his bench and have those guys step up.
Cashaw foul. Looks like they'll get Sebring. Instead, it's Connor Oltman.
Oltman got more arm than ball on that swipe. He's trying to keep Cashaw in front of him. Connor shouldn't feel bad, because a lot of people can't keep Connor Cashaw in front of them when he's coming at him full steam.
Cashaw, big night last night when Jalen Brunson struggled early against Bolingbrook. Cashaw ended up with 14 points, 12 rebounds, 3 assists, and 6 steals. This is a couple of free tosses there.
He struggled down in Peoria the previous 2 years in the semis and championship games. Last night he was huge, but he's going through a little struggle now in this first half.
Oldman battles on the board. He'll be touched last by Johnson.
Get a look at how important this game is to these players. Johnson, Oldman, Brunson in there just battling against each other. Trying to get this basketball. Look at Oldman flying to your screen. This is what this championship means to these young men out here on this court.
We have been stuck on his 23-17 score for a while, and we haven't had a basket in this game for over 4 minutes.
And that's surprising with the talent on the court, but David Boyd says, hey, Dave, with that stat, just ball it up, throw it in the trash, because I'm going to get this basket and give myself a hand one. Huge play from Mr. Boyd off the ball screen. Running downhill with that basketball. And what I love about David Boyd, when he gets his shoulders past his defenders, he's so strong in his upper body that he can take defenders up with him and take contact and still finish the play.
Boyd, wide receiver on the Big 12 conference champion Ironman football team, cannot convert. So that's 3 free throws here in this stretch of defensive stops that Normal has not been able to get through.
But they're still down 4, Dave, so they're still in this game. But again, you get back to it. And it sounds like I'm beating a dead horse, but it's a championship game. You have to take those opportunities when they present themselves. Leaving points at the free throw line will hurt you.
And that stretch without a basket for Stevenson continues.
Connor Cashaw is 1 of 5 from the field in this, 1 of 6, I'm sorry, from the field in this first half, and only 2 points. He has to get himself going offensively, but right now he can take a back seat because Brunson has carried the Patriots. But in the second half, Cashaw has to step up.
Under 20 seconds, clock on the move. Normal Community, those will be content taking that last shot. To Boyd. 6.3 seconds left. The ball underneath the Normal basket.
I like the decision from Boyd. You get him out in space and allow him to operate with his speed and his upper body strength. Now with 6.3 left, see if Normal can get a great look. But you have to go to Tyler Sebring. He needs that basketball in this moment.
Up top it comes to Meyer. Knocked away by Cashaw. Can he get it off? He does!
How about that? Connor Cashaw going to Rice University next year. An amazing steal and great speed in the open court to beat the clock for that layup. How about that for good vibes going into halftime for the Patriots?
The impressive part about this for Cashaw, as he is sprinting down the floor, he glances above the backboard to check the time.
And that basketball is going towards the sideline, so he has to change his angle to go get it and then make a V-line right back to the basket to get that layup to go. Very nice.
Let's go to Kelly.
Thanks a lot, guys, here with Coach Ambrose. Well, the pace, probably what you liked, wanted to see from your guys, but assess that first half.
Pace was pretty good. We want to go a little faster, but we got some defensive stops and kind of a low-scoring game, so we'll take it.
7 turnovers, yes, defensively you have to like, but what Connor Cashaw just did, how big of a momentum shift is that going into that?
We hope it's a huge moment. We hope it's a propel us momentum for the second half. Jalen had a dunk yesterday, so hope Connor's layup will be the same.
All right, Coach, best of luck. Guys?
Normal trailed by 4. They were holding for the final shot to try to cut that lead. And then Connor Cashaw, the glance to the basket, the drive. He beats the buzzer, and it's a 6-point lead for the Patriots at the half.
Championship broadcasts are brought to you by Realtor.com's mobile app. Get the most accurate app for finding homes for sale and for rent. Halftime here of our Class 4A state championship game. The Patriots of Stevenson with a 6-point lead. 16 minutes away from Jalen Brunson if he can get that elusive state championship. Time for a trivia question here at Carver Arena. And as we often do, our National Association of Realtors trivia question. They've been tough ones. Well, we'll see about this one here. What captain of the 1989 Flying Illini team starred in high school at West Aurora and spent 11 years in the NBA? Anybody have the answer? Think about that. And while you're thinking about that, Realtor.com's real estate app. Find home first. Get the most accurate app for finding homes for sale and for rent. If you said Kenny Battle, you got it. Kenny Battle, star of the Flying Illini team, here in the mid-80s among those teams that got down here from, say, Simeon and from Evanston, right in the mix for West Aurora. Kenny Battle and Gordy Kirkman, who just won his 800th game, by the way, so congratulations to him. Time for our Realtor.com move of the game. Connor Cashaw looking at the clock on the steal to find out how much he's got left, hitting the floor and getting the layup as we end the first half. He has struggled on this floor, and he knows it. Happy to get that bucket and to be up by six. Stevenson, up by six here at the break. We'll be back.
Welcome back to Peoria for the 4A Boys State Finals. Stevenson leading Normal Community right now 25-19. I'm with head coach here for the Ironmen, Dave Witzig. And first of all, the final play of that first half, Connor Cashaw getting to the rim there. Was that really deflating for your team heading into the locker room?
Yeah, I mean, that was a bummer. You know, we're down four with the ball and looking to try to get a 2 or 3 point shot, and they end up stealing, getting a layup. So, yeah, 6 points off layup steals from us. So that's a good job by them. But I told our guys, if you told us a month ago it's halftime, we're down six in the state championship game to Stevenson, we'd say we'll take it. So we didn't play great, but we gave ourselves a chance to play a great 16 minutes and see what we can do.
All right, well, you really did slow them down, a 16-point first quarter for Stevenson and then nine. How do you keep that pace at what you want it to be here in the last half?
Yeah, you know, they're so explosive offensively. We just got to do a good job of staying in front of them, and Brunson's a problem, but their other guys are stepping up, and we did play a good second quarter. Our problem right now is on the offensive end. Their defense is, they're long, they're athletic, they're quick, they're doing a great job of making it tough for us to make any successful pass, so our offense has got to get a lot better.
All right, Coach, thank you so much for your time. Good luck.
Thank you.
There you go, the Ironmen looking to get something going here in the final 60 minutes, the boys 4A state championships. We're going to take a quick timeout and be right back with the final two quarters.
25-19 as we get set to start the third quarter. Thanks for coming and joining us here at Carver Arena. Dave Bernhardt along with Cameron Smith. And Cameron, Tyler Sebring's come up big. 6.7 rebounds, but they need a little bit more.
They need Alex Peacock. He had only 2 points in that first half, only two shot attempts in that first half. But Normal, they're shooting 47% from the floor, and they're only down six. So those are good areas for them going forward in the second half. But they have to slow down Jalen Brunson. They are within striking distance. You heard Coach Dave Witzig say, hey, he would have told us that we would be down six in the state championship game. He said they're in good spots. But this is Jalen Brunson. This is what he's done in this first half. 15 points, and he got his 15 points on an array of moves from the outside, on the inside, getting the end one. He is a dynamic player that has really proven why he's the best guard in this country.
Normal Community shooting at 47%. They've done a good job, and when they've been able to execute, however, eight turnovers have led to eight Stevenson points.
And the primary person that caused those turnovers was Connor Cashaw. Five steals for Connor in that first half. Defensively, he was huge on the getting steals and on Alex Peacock.
There's Tyler Sebring headed to Elon University, the Colonial Athletic Conference, honorable mention All-Stater. It's a 6'7 senior.
Coach Witzig is still going to continue to guard Brunson one-on-one, but you have to believe that they're going to send another defender to kind of spy Brunson when he makes those dribble attacks towards the rim. Cannot allow them to get comfortable on this end of the floor. You see Thompson there just spying Brunson, making him give that basketball up. Those are small wins. They might be not important to a lot of people, but as a basketball enthusiast, those are small wins when you're able to give up that basketball from your star player and make someone else beat you.
43 seconds off the clock, and Stevenson came away empty.
Trying to get that basketball down there to Alex Peacock, and it's a good trap from Matt Johnson. He's going to be called for a foul. Didn't need that one. But they're looking for Alex Peacock. He had great position with Connor Cashaw on his back.
You know, you get the sense that the way that first half ended for Normal Community, it's the way this second half begins for the Ironmen that will be so crucial for them.
Well, you are right. Well, this could potentially be the final half for a lot of these players. You think of the seniors and Alex Peacock, and you think about Tyler Sebring. These guys want to make sure that they're finishing their careers on the high school level on top.
Boyd left open for three. That would have cut the lead in half. Hey. Brunson got there, and Stevenson will still have the ball.
Another good defensive stand from the Ironmen.
Tyler Sebring, that time coming over on Brunson, is quick hands from Tyler Vance as well.
Another rebound for Sebring.
Well, Vance is very fortunate on that play that Brunson didn't complete that layup. Quick hitter out of that out of bounds play.
Brunson the pick. Cruises all the way and can't finish. The tip, no. Again, no. Sebring the tip out to Peacock.
We've seen Brunson miss two consecutive layups right at the rim. That is very rare from that young man. He gets his opportunity to score. He usually capitalizes.
Speaking of capitalizing, that is one thing the Normal has not been able to do when they've shut down the Patriots at the other end. Johnson. A cold start here to the third quarter.
Both teams are getting good looks, Dave. They're just not finishing these plays. Nothing is being forced. They're getting to the rim. They're getting open looks from the perimeter. They just have to make shots.
Oh, the Normal fans will not like that call.
And I'm in agreement with them. That should have been a foul call on Matt Johnson. You cannot take out the legs of a player. And that's exactly what happened. And you take Johnson out of that equation with Vance, and I know Johnson is hustling for that basketball, but if Johnson isn't there, Boyd gets that basketball and secures that possession.
We are stuck at 25-19.
Bolt. I'm sorry, I just got caught up in Jalen Brunson dancing. How about that, Justin Smith? Nice little fading mid-range jumper.
Lead is pushed to 8.
He had his moments in the first half on the offensive end where he just got to the rim a couple of drives, showcasing his athleticism. Now he's showing the perimeter game.
Sebring looking to maneuver on Nichols. Peacock. Thompson, good shooter. Still nothing here in the opening 3-plus minutes for the Ironmen. Smith again.
Up and down pace that Stevenson loves to play, but if you're Normal, you have to slow things down and get this game in the half court. And it starts by getting the ball to that man there.
Peacock. That's an offensive foul. That is his third foul of this game.
Well, there he is again. Parker Nichols, another charge in this basketball game. Sliding over, help side defense. Takes the contact and gets the call. That is a great defensive play from the senior.
Not sure what that is, but it's frightening.
Is it an angry Eminem? About a frustrated Eminem, I'm not sure.
Well, if he's frustrated, there's reason for it, as Normal's missed all three of their shots. On the other side, Stevenson's made just one of six here in the second half, but that one has given them an 8-point lead.
Cold shooting from both teams, but only an 8-point lead for the Patriots. But what they do in this third quarter, this is where they separate themselves from their opponents. They've done it all season. Get into this mode offensively where they're getting to the line, they're knocking down threes, and they just create that separation. Now, for Normal, they have to take the challenge right now. And that's not just on the defensive end, it's on the offensive end as well. That's a good shot from David Boyd. Great job. As I talked about, Dave, when we started this third quarter, trying to see if Coach Whitzig will send another defender over at Brunson. And boy, good recognition here. Saw Brunson driving, just ran right over, got his hands on the ball, and caused that jump ball. Now Normal gets the possession.
Pat Ambrose tried to get a timeout, but obviously the tie-up was taking place with no possession. So once again, the Ironmen need a score. They have not scored here in the first 4 minutes of this half, and they won't score on this possession.
And that ball's going to go right back to the Patriots. So, Dave, how many times have we seen this evening in this game for Normal when they cause the turnover, either they don't score or they give it right back to the Patriots?
There's not a stat on our stat sheet that reveals that number.
No.
But
but it's been plentiful in this ball game.
The ball in an 8-point lead for Stevenson, looking for their first state basketball championship, looking to combine it with their Class 8A football championship in this past fall.
Good defensive play from Alex Peacock, taking that challenge against Connor Cashaw. How about that? Nice floater right there.
Mason Meyer, the 6'3 senior.
Little Derrick Rose on that floater. Don't see that too often from that area of the floor, someone going with the floater, but Mason says, hey, I got that in my game, Cameron. I can do that. In transition, too. Here comes Mason again. In transition off the catch, a couple of dribbles, and he just floats that thing up. You got to have some great confidence and touch to take that shot.
Meyer, one of several members on this basketball team. They're also members of the second-place soccer team this past fall. Brunson gets his 16th point. Take a look behind Jalen Brunson over his shoulder. Up above, that's the Stevenson section. And it rings that corner.
Dave, I think that just might be a third of the school. You look at that, the school's population. Yeah, close to 4,000 students. If you've ever been to Stevenson High School, it should be called Stevenson University, just the amount of buildings and how big that campus is.
In and out for Peacock. Brunson all the way to the rack.
Well, he had one thing in mind, and that's get to the rack. And that's a big jump ball from Matt Johnson.
The 10-point lead, the biggest of the night. It belongs to the Patriots.
Well, Brunson on the break. He is lethal. He understood what the defense was giving him in Farrington, and Farrington had no chance. A little quick hesitation from Brunson, and he gets to the rim with the best of them.
19 points tonight. Four quick ones here in the third quarter.
How about him bouncing back from last night? He struggled offensively, and when people look up the stats from Brunson from last night, he had 21 points, and he did a number of things with his assists and his rebounds. Could have had a triple-double, but we thought he was struggling last night. He had 21 points. Here's another turnover for Normal Community. Just on different pages with Boyd and Sebring. Sebring throwing that ball a little behind Boyd. Calls that ball to go out.
It's the 13th turnover of the night for the Normal Community Ironmen, and Jalen Brunson makes them pay.
Well, it's surging time. It is surging time, Dave, and he could feel it. See him yelling out to himself saying, let's go. This is a dangerous part of the game for Dave Witzek's crew. They desperately need some good vibes before this quarter ends.
Boyd hammered as he is headed to the basket.
David Boyd again aggressive on the ball. Going to put the pressure on Matt Johnson. He's going to get to the free throw line. Jalen Brunson, my goodness. That pull-up jumper is lethal. And we saw Glenn Watson in that 3A championship game for St. Joe's against Altoff Catholic. And his pull-up jump shot on the break. And those guys just stopping on a dime and raising and knocking those shots down. That is so difficult to do. Just essentially stopping all of your momentum and challenging yourself to knock down a jumper. It's almost like you're kind of defying gravity a little bit. Stopping your momentum and then forcing your body upwards in the upward motion and to shoot that ball. That is difficult.
After a couple of free throws, Boyd will be replaced by Tyler Vance.
These are big free throws for Coach Wizick. Now they're going to change their defense, extending their pressure up the court, trying to get a quick trap to see Peacock on the ball.
Nearly a steal by Vance.
And it's just a tad bit too late on that steal. That would have been huge for the Ironmen.
90 seconds left, third quarter.
Just keep running their offense, trying to have some options out of it. See if Brunson can create.
the hands of Smith. Somehow Jalen Brunson saw Justin Smith through traffic inside a little bit too high. Smith can't hang on.
He saw him. He threw a laser right to the hands of Justin Smith. Look at the strength on this pass to get that ball over there. It's a little too high for Justin Smith, and you usually don't hear that for a kid like Justin Smith because he can jump out of the gym.
Peacock doubled up. Pikes through it. My goodness.
That was nice. The strength of Alex Peacock. I mean, and the beautiful thing about this move from Alex is the use of his pivot feet. I mean, you look at Alex, he's going to spin away from the double team, use the baseline, and use the rim as a protector to go on the other side and lay that up. He's patient on the block area. That's why he is a second-team All-State player, because when he's in that area, he understands that, hey, I have all day to work my defender. I can get anything that I want. I have the size, I have the strength, and I know what to do with this basketball. I've been doing this since I was a kid.
56 seconds left in third. Pretty important 56 seconds right here for Normal. They trail by six at the end of the first half. They've got that lead under double digits, and you've got to believe they'd like to get back in that 6-7 point range here going into the fourth.
Well, Dave, it was a 13-point lead almost a couple of minutes ago, and look at this guy get down. That's a way to get some air time.
Delay. Alex Peacock coming out. I think he was asked to leave.
Saw Peacock on that baseline and he took a shot to the nose. And then treat that with the Ironman athletic trainer and try and get him back into this ball game. Gotta wipe that blood away before he comes out and gets the court again.
And will the Patriots hang on here for the final 40 seconds?
Clock will tick down, and Justin Smith says, hey, forget that. I'm trying to get to the bucket. Nice pass.
Ooh.
In and out for Cashel. Now, basket here for Norman will be huge going into this fourth quarter.
Vance to the right side. Mayer. Another floater. No. Chance here for Cashaw on the race again. Johnson, does he get it off? It does not go. So a 9-point Stevenson lead as we head to the fourth. One of these teams will win their first state basketball championship. The stars are shining in Peoria, and right now the lead belongs to Stevenson. For your auto, home, life, business, and retirement needs, call the Country Financial representative near you at 1-866-COUNTRY or visit us at countryfinancial.com. Those folks have been on their feet at the opening horn of this game. Let's check in quickly with Kelly Crowell.
David Boyd, guys, putting his arm around all the guys in that huddle last time out, saying, guys, this is the last quarter of our high school careers. Let's make it count. Lay it all on the line right now, trying to get his guys fired up.
You know, you hear that, Cameron, and you realize how meaningful it is at this level, maybe more so than any other level, for that very thing, the last quarter.
Because a lot of these players won't go on to play college basketball. And this could be it for a lot of guys to play organized basketball as Brunson draws a foul on Tyler Vance. And so these are the moments as a senior that you cherish because you're not sure on what the future holds for you in your basketball career.
Vance picked up two quick fouls in the first 8 seconds. He has four fouls. He'll have a seat replaced by Dwayne Farrington.
That's a huge blow to the pressure defense for Coach Whitson. Having Tyler Vance on that bench makes it even tougher trying to keep Stevenson out of that lane.
Poked away from Smith. The turnover will give the ball to the Ironman.
It's a good start for the Ironman to start this fourth quarter. Down nine. But again, Tyler Sebring, Alex Peacock especially, they have to step up and get buckets
for their ball club. It's the only way that they're going to come back and win this game.
Barrington very strong.
How about Barrington taking on Justin Smith right to the rim, grinding out Smith with that dribble, and then the body control to finish that layup.
The lead at 7, 34-27. Brunson picking a spot and finding it.
I mean, he pulled that ball from his hip pocket to get it up and into the rim. This is the degree of difficulty from Barrington and Brunson on those baskets. It's just outstanding.
Sebring has a shot blocked by Cashaw, but a foul.
Well, we look at the talent that we have on this court, and Dwayne Farrington is one of those talented players. Counter Cashaw not sliding over to help out his teammate, and back on the other end, Jalen Brunson just up and under for that play. Just the strength to get that shot up and then to put the touch on it to score, it is huge.
Looking at Tyler Sebring, 6'7 senior, came into this tournament averaging 14.4 points per game. He's had a combined 10 points now through seven quarters here in the semis and championship game.
Honorable mention all state for class 4A. And it's not typical of Tyler to miss free throws. He shoots 79% on the season.
10 rebounds tonight, however, for Sebring, who gets that one to roll in.
What he's lacking scoring, he's made up in rebounding. And they are actually winning the rebounding battle against the Patriots, so that's huge for Normal.
They get it to Brunson. No look bounce for the score.
Wow, again, the recognition. He knows that all eyes on him are on him in the black jerseys, so he finds Matt Johnson just waiting for that basketball.
Double-digit lead for Stevenson. Johnson the pick.
Pat Ambrose calls Matt Johnson the defensive bulldog, and you get a little taste of that tenacity from Matt Johnson. Taking the cookies and finishing it off for 2 points. That is big.
And those folks up there are starting to smell it. Still 6:15 to play, but a 12-point lead thanks to Matt Johnson.
Well, Matt Johnson tells David Boyd, hey, let me get that right there. We'll come back down, lay this thing up, and that will energize my team. Transferred from Batavia High School over to Stevenson before his junior season. And this young man has been outstanding on the defensive end. Just being able to fit within Pat Ambrose's system and understand his role amongst the superstars of Jalen Brunson and Connor Cashaw. He doesn't care about scoring. He doesn't care about assists. He just cares about getting underneath the skin of his opponents.
Sebring knocks it down.
That's tough, and he actually got hit on the top of the head before he took that jump shot, too. Tyler Sebring trying to will his team back in this game, but they're going to need turnovers as Pat Ambrose calls a timeout.
Yeah, he did not like the position Cashaw was in.
It's just such a luxury for coaches to have that they can call timeouts for their players when they're in a tough spot.
Well, a little less than 4 months ago, Stevenson football team, they were looking for their first state football championship, led by quarterback Willie Bourbon. Bourbon will take this one in, and Stevenson had a safe lead until Homan Crossmore came back. And a late fumble going in for a potential game-winning score by the Vikings. Gave the ball back to Stevenson, and the Patriots win the 8A state football title. 31-25 over Homan Crossmore. And tonight they look to become the third team in Illinois high school history to win football and basketball championships in the same year.
They are 5:53 away, David. That put a lot of pressure on the basketball program to try and come through with the state title after being down in Peoria for the previous 2 years. But a lot of the players on this basketball team are great friends with the football players of Stevenson High School. and I'm sure they're having a friendly competition amongst each other. And Cameron Green, who's an outstanding wide receiver and safety for Stevenson, he'll play at Northwestern next season, also plays on the basketball team, but has been out all season because of a shoulder injury that he suffered in the football year.
No problem with the pressure there.
Coach Witzig calling out 11 to his team. But I believe it's going to be a trap coming soon.
Brunson in the lane for two. Jalen Brunson with his 26th point, a 4A championship game record, breaking by one a record set by Sterling Brown of Proviso East in 2012.
What records hasn't Jalen Brunson broken in his high school career? It just seems like he has everything underneath his name.
Thompson. And now the run out. Justin Smith finishes it. It's a 14-point Stevenson lead.
But Justin Smith is limping up the floor, but I think he's a little more embarrassed than he is hurt, because he thought he was going to be able to fly high. And believe me, Justin can get up. And look at Matt Johnson on the defensive end. He just doesn't stop. Justin Blanca Tyler on that layup. But how about Jalen Brunson? He has the 4A game title record in points, 26. It's like blood in the water to a shark. He can smell this state championship, and he's going to fight his way to it. He is outstanding and has been special all night.
Stevenson in charge, a 14-point lead with a little bit more than 4.5 minutes left before a state championship. Matt Rodewald here at Carver Arena. What a weekend of basketball it's been. Started things off with a special performance from Marcus Levitt with 45 points. We got to see a second state championship for Gene Pingitore in St. Joe's. We might see history here tonight. You know, guys, 2 years ago, before the Stevenson and Simeon matchup in 2013, I had a 5-minute conversation with then a young sophomore by the name of Jalen Brunson. I asked him if he felt confident to win that game. He said, oh, yeah. And then they got humbled by 20. The look on his face then said he knew he had a lot more work to do to get to a state championship game and to win it. I think he realizes now how much work it's been, and it's about to pay off.
Yeah, that look, man, is completely changed. You talk about a player who has been focused these last two games, but tonight especially. For all the times we've seen Jalen Brunson, tonight there was just a different type of look, just that little extra. As you've said, Cameron, this was his time.
Well, the losses in Peoria the previous 2 years has really fueled Jalen, because I'm sure it's done that in his workouts, thinking about those losses, going up and thinking, what could I have done better to give my team this win? So when he's going through his workouts and he's shooting his jumpers and trying to knock things down and just trying to fine-tune his game for when that next opportunity comes, it's tonight, and he's really relished in this moment.
Justin Smith with the foul on Peacock.
Just really turned himself into an outstanding player. And he said he really got serious about the game of basketball after his freshman year and really turned up his workouts. And I'm just going to give you a small taste of what Jalen Brunson goes through in the right before the basketball season. This is Jalen Brunson's schedule, all right? Now, when school is done at 2:30, he goes and shoots every day from 3 to 4 p.m. He'll lift weights from 5 to 6 p.m. 3 days a week with a strength coach. He's lifting weights. He stretches twice a week with a stretch coach from 6 to 7 p.m. Completes his homework. He makes sure that he gets his academics, his books done. Because of his mom, Sandra Brunson, she holds that part of the duties for the family. And finally, after homework is complete, he shoots by himself 3 times a week late night when he's done with everything. Now, that's the mark of someone that wants to be great. You have to put the time in into your craft to make sure that you're doing everything in your power to get to that next level.
That is a very impressive regimen that he goes through. And that is going to enable him to get to that free throw line again.
Looking with that basketball in his hands, he is not going to give it up. Just understands how to shield the ball away from defenders with his body. And a lot of things that he does on the court, Dave, are things you can't teach. He just has it in his genes.
beat by a couple of defenders. Johnson all the way back out to Nichols, to cash off to Brunson, and they'll start here with 3:45 to play.
It's almost keep away time for the Patriots. Just trying to run some time off that clock and continue to keep normal scrambled on the defensive end.
Knocked away to Boyd, a 2-on-1. Peacock unable to find the range. Mayer. Nope. Johnson, he has numbers if he wants them.
Smart decision from Brunson to pull that ball out. Saw what happened on the previous possession. He turned it over trying to feed Rosenbaum. That time he elected to give it back out to Matt Johnson and run some more time off the clock.
That is the 16th foul on Normal Community. Now Brunson will go to the line.
It's all about getting to the free throw line and knocking him down. The more you're fouled, you get to that line, add more points to your lead, and it gives you even more comfort as this game goes forward. So now with 3:05 left for Stevenson, they're looking at that clock, saying, man, that time is not moving fast enough. And if you're Coach Witzig of Normal, we don't have enough time to try and get back within this game. But one way to do that is to continue to get steals. You stop the clock by trying to draw fouls on Stevenson and get to the free throw line. But it's going to be a tall task given this deficit that they're facing.
Well, in that routine that Jalen Brunson goes through, I assume there's some free throw shooting going on. He is 7-for-7 tonight. He was 13-of-14 from the line last night. 20-of-21 here in the tournament.
Outstanding. And Dave, I'll say this about free throw shooting. That's a part of the game that has really been on the decline for a lot of young players. They don't really value that as much as the crossover dribble or trying to dunk on someone. When you're at the free throw line, you have to make sure that you're going through your routines, you're confident, and that you've done enough or gone through enough repetitions that when you step there, it's natural, and you're making sure you're knocking down your shots.
Two shots halfway down and rolling out. And Cashaw capitalizes on the other end.
Connor Cashaw in transition. He gets past you, you better believe he's going to go all the way for that layup. And that's a nice stroke from Tyler Seaver.
Double digits with 12, his second three. The lead remains 13. Smith. Yes.
Textbook play, and it's a smart move from Jalen Brunson. He could have easily tried to lob that ball up to Justin Smith. But the bad thing about that is it could lead to a turnover. So he gave him the bounce pass and allowed Smith to finish off that play.
Peacock will try a three. You. Brunson out of there with it. And you heard some skin being slapped on that drive to the basket. And this is a very tired Normal Community team right now. Mentally and physically.
The Ironmen tried to come out and run with Stevenson. I'll tell you, when you try and do that, you're going to end up on the other side of the basketball game.
See, hands on hips, hands on knees as Brunson picked up his 29th point of the night.
And you look at it on the opposite side for the Patriots. They're smiling, they're high-fiving each other, and a lot of that has to do because they know it's only 1:48 left in this ball game, and they are right there to become the new state champions in 4A in the state of Illinois.
A rejection.
That from Justin Smith. I mean, he's just being a bully right now. He doesn't care that there's not a lot of time left in this game. He's still going to play defense.
He is going to be the man for Pat Ambrose next season.
Cashaw will pick up the personal foul.
Jalen Brunson, and see this fan on Twitter, know who he's voting for Mr. Basketball, who he thinks should be Mr. Basketball. Got a little Zach Galifianakis look there, too, with that beard.
Peacock will get the bucket and a quick timeout called by Normal. A country financial player of the game. Well, how about the guy with 30 points, 9 of 15 from the floor, 9 of 9 from the line. He's knocked down three triples.
Well, he has done everything in this basketball game. He's given everything that Normal expected of him. The drives to the basket, you've seen the jump shot, getting down, challenging Tyler Sebring. This is a young man that has come up short two straight years in Peoria for that state championship. It's his final go around, and he came out and he played an outstanding floor game.
And kudos to all of those folks. A lot of times on Fridays, we see the big student sections. Everything is all organized. You miss some school, it's a good thing. And then on Saturdays, things dwindle. Not for those people from Stevenson.
Not at all. The support, and that's the Stevenson community showing support with their fellow, for their fellow students. And see that Teletubby in there, that yellow sticking out amongst the black shirts. How about the parade that's going to be held in Lincolnshire for these young men?
There is your country financial player of the game, Jalen Brunson. 30 of his team's 52 points. Trying to foul, Brunson will dribble it away. Finally, Thompson will get Smith. And now that will stop the clock and will enable Normal Community to bring in five new players. And listen to the hand their starters will get.
See these players from Normal Community coming out of this ball game. A lot of them with their heads down, but hey, they have nothing at all to be disappointed about. They shocked this entire state by getting to this state championship game, and as they get older, they'll realize the history that they made in their high school careers.
And now the same will be done for Stevenson. One by one, the Patriots come off the floor.
Talk about persevering through adverse times. And Jalen Brunson is the epitome of that. An outstanding career for one of the best point guards this state has ever seen. He's going to go to Villanova University next season. A McDonald's All-American. And just an outstanding basketball player. And an even better young man. And Dave, we have been so fortunate to witness Jalen Brunson, Jabari Parker, Jahlil Okafor in consecutive years.
How about
you think about that? Jabari Parker, number two pick in the 2014 NBA draft. Jahlil Okafor, who in my opinion should be the number one pick in this year's upcoming draft. Jalen Brunson, only time will tell what he will do. If he can make it to the NBA, I believe he will get there in due time. But the talent that we have seen in these past 5 years has been amazing. We are very lucky in the state of Illinois. Cameron Green, two really good friends, hugging and enjoying this moment. Cameron Green is getting his jewelry game up. He got a state championship in football. He's going to get that ring. He's got a state championship in basketball. Now he has to decide on what ring or what finger he's going to put that basketball championship on.
Three on the way. Knock it down for Nate Komnick.
Well, that's good to see Nate knocking down that three-point shot. This has been a great weekend of high school basketball.
Joshua McMullen with it. He's going to launch a three. Yes!
Oh, how about that? Go ahead, Josh.
And that may have brought the biggest cheer of the night from his teammate.
This is the loudest we've heard the Stevenson Patriots student section all night. Look at Josh knock this down. No conscience at all. Look at that. That is great to see. Enjoying the moment for your teammate. You look at the relationship these players have, and it's just amazing to see when they're cheering for their buddies, cheering for them to do well.
Josh McMullen leaves the game. What a way to go out.
Yes. Well, he has bragging rights now. Hey, I knocked down a deep three-pointer in the 4A state championship. It won the game. That's the biggest story he'll tell when he gets older.
And your 4A champions, the Stevenson Patriots. Say that the third time is the charm, because it was a three-year journey for Stevenson to get to this very point, the 4A state champions.
This is a great lesson for a lot of young people out there watching this broadcast. As many times as you get knocked down, you got to get back up and continue to push and persevere forward.
Let's go to Kelly.
Jalen, 30 points tonight. You've been waiting a long time for this moment. Is it as special as you envisioned?
I can't even explain. I can't even speak right now. I'm just so happy. Worked so hard for this. You know, we failed twice. But, I mean, it was well worth the wait, man. I'm really excited. And I'm just really honored and blessed.
You can tell you're very emotional. With the senior group that you had, we saw you jumping up and down with some of the last guys you got in, got to have that final moment on the court. What will you take away, remember about this group and this run?
It's my friends, man. I mean, we worked so hard for this. I mean, Coach Ambrose, everybody, the whole coaching staff, the whole community, Stevenson community. I mean, it's just a real honor. I just can't even speak right now.
To know that you're bringing home the first ever basketball championship for your school, and yet your football team did it this year, which has never been done with a big school. What is that going to be like when you guys get back to class on Monday?
It's going to be, just really one special moment, man. I mean, everyone in the senior group, the whole school worked hard and everything. I mean, there's so much stuff that our school can improve on, and the things we excel at, it's amazing.
Jalen, congratulations. Enjoy this one.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
There you go, guys.
There are the medals that will be soon awarded here as they are spread out upon the table.
Well, this Stevenson Patriots team, again, an outstanding season. You see Jalen Brunson embracing athletic director Trish Betthauser from Stevenson High School. And he has just been so impactful to this basketball program, and Pat Ambrose, just an outstanding career and the perfect way to finish off your high school career.
Let's go to Pat Ambrose and Kelly.
Absolutely, Coach. It's maybe a little bit cliche to say third time's a charm, but how rewarding is this one?
Yeah, we worked very hard for 3 years, and we finally kind of got over the hump or finally did what we needed to do. The other 2 years, we were very close, but this year is obviously very special.
We just got to talk to Jalen a couple of minutes. Very emotional. How emotional is this for you?
Very emotional, too. But, I mean, he's incredible. He puts everything into every play, so I'm not surprised he's emotional.
and a very close senior group. I know all the guys had a big part of this season and this run. When you reflect back at the end of the year, what is it you're going to take away from this?
That senior group, how great they were, and off the court and on the court, how wonderful they were as student athletes.
What more can you say about this student section, the crowd you had, the community support?
Pretty amazing, pretty amazing. The championship culture we have at Stevenson is top-notch.
Well, Coach, go enjoy this one with your team. Congratulations. Pat Ambrose, Dave.
It is a exhilarating time and yet a very difficult time, because not only did the state title end up in the hands of Stevenson, it is over for this senior group, and that is why you see so many tears on this final night in anywhere, whether it's a regional championship or maybe even the first game of a regional, because it is truly the last time these people will all be together.
And these players are thinking about all of the practices, the shoot-arounds, the bus trips, all the adversity and challenges that they've gone through and successes that they've gone through throughout their entire careers. And to finish it off on this moment, on this stage, for that state championship is a great way to put an exclamation point on your individual careers.
See the media huddling around Jalen Brunson. And they're about to get set to get their medals. Let's go to Paul Herzog.
Presenting medallions will be Dr. Jeanette Knuckles and Dr. Chuck Nagel. This time, meet the Ironman of Normal Community, finishing second place in 4A, a record of 33-2. The associate principal, Nikki Maurer. The athletic director, Andrew Turner. Assistant principal, Anthony Clark.
Good job, Andy. Thanks. Thanks.
Trainer, Devin Shannon.
Congratulations.
Head coach, David Witzig. Assistant coach, Nate Foster.
Good job, Dave.
Assistant coach, Ryan Short. Assistant coach, Matt Schweinberg. Assistant coach, Derek Schonauer. Assistant coach, Jason Harden. And now the Ironman, three, Mason Meyer. Four, Mitch Turner. Five, Nate Komnick. 10, Tyler Vance. 11, David Boyd. 12, Jim Leone. 21, Zach Thompson. 22, Connor Altman. 23, Alex Peacock. 30, Brady Karstens. 32, Dwayne Farrington. 33, Tyler Sebring. 40, Connor Dibble. 42, Ethan Pogge. Congratulations, the Ironman. Second place, 4A, 2015. Presenting medallions, Dan Klett, assisted by Gerald Morrow. Let's meet the Patriots of Lincolnshire Stevenson. First place, 2015, 4A. Superintendent, Dr. Eric Twaddell. Principal Troy Gobble. Athletic Director Trish Bethauser. Certified Athletic Trainer Tyler Coleman. Head Coach Pat Ambrose. Assistant Coach John Taylor. Assistant Coach Pat Swan. Assistant Coach Kevin Steinman. Assistant Coach David Hess. Assistant Coach Mike Fay. And now the Patriots. One, Connor Cashaw. Three, Justin Smith. Five, Parker Nichols. Ten, Joshua McMullen. 11, Ryan Rosenbaum. 12, Matthew Johnson. 13, Ruji Aoki. 15, Jalen Brunson. 20, Radek Gralak. 21, Benjamin Rodheim. 22, Eric Zaleski. 24, Jordan Newman. 25, Jordan Hodes. Hodes. 35, Kevin Yang. 36, Cameron Green. And Nick Dillon. The Patriots of Lincolnshire Stevenson, first place. 4A, 2015. Presenting the second place trophy will be Director Greg Bradley. Will Coach Witzig and the captains of Normal Community step forward to receive the second place trophy? Congratulations. Presenting the first place trophy, Dan Klett. Coach Ambrose and the captains of Stevenson, please step forward to receive the first place trophy, 2014 4A Boys Basketball IHSA. Thanks to all and congratulations to fans, family, and friends for a great year for both schools. We hope you enjoyed your stay at America's Original March Madness here in Peoria. Thank you for joining us. See you for the next 5 years, wherever you're driving next, please.
So congratulations to the Stevenson Patriots, and also congratulations to the Ironmen from Normal Community. How about Normal? The seniors for Normal Community were eighth graders sitting up in these stands 4 years ago, and now they have a second place trophy.
Well, hopefully they set the tone for those incoming freshmen next year for that high school, and just an outstanding job from them all season long, wearing that Cinderella slipper and just shocking a lot of teams across the state of Illinois. Again, they shouldn't hold their heads down for any reason. They are a great ball club, and they made history for themselves tonight.
And Pat Ambrose, you heard him moments ago saying, well, we finally got over the hump. A lot of teams say that when it's maybe winning a regional championship. That's a big hump to get and win a state title.
It's an enormous hump for that Stevenson Patriots basketball program. But think about this. They lose 2 years in a row on this very floor, coming up short of their state championship goals. This year, they get it done. And how about Jalen Brunson? Outstanding. What a way to finish your prep career with a state championship.
And 30 points on this floor. This has been 4 weeks of America's Original March Madness, and there have been so many people working so hard to bring these games to you with the highest quality. We run down the list: Peter Rudman, Russ Leonard, Mario Calero, and right on down behind the scenes in a truck for four straight weeks. We thank Lee Hall, along with our partner next door, Bo Spencer, for stats all weekend. Of course, Tom Doerr as well. Ryan Scheffler made things happen. My partner Cameron Smith, and of course, Michelle McMahon, along with Matt Rodewald and Kelly Crow. I'm Dave Bernhardt. It has been a ride here tonight for the Stevenson Patriots, their first state basketball championship, and it comes here in Peoria, the home of America's original March Madness.
And welcome back to Carver Arena. It is time for our third and fourth place trophies. And for that presentation, let's send it to our public address announcer, Mr. Paul Herzog.
Your attention to midcourt for the third and fourth place awards. The IHSA 4A third place state championship. Making the presentation of medallions and trophies to the board of directors that are here today. President Dan Klett of Wakanda, representing Division II. Vice President Dr. Chuck Nagel of East Peoria, Division VI. Secretary B. Kent Jones of Breeze Central, Division 7. John Stimler of Chicago Mount Carmel, Division 1. Robert Nolting of Tinley Park Andrew, Division 3. Gerald Morrow of Chicago Dunbar, an at-large member. Dr. Jeanette Knuckles at Urbana University High, an at-large member. Peter Groom of Oak Park Fenwick, an at-large member. And Greg Bradley of Forsyth Decatur Christian, board-appointed treasurer. Before we continue with the awards, the IHSA, I'd like to take a special moment to recognize Marty Hickman, who's in the midst of his final boys' play tournament as executive director of the Illinois High School Association. Marty will retire next January after serving high school students in Illinois for over 30 years as a high school teacher, coach, principal, and then member of the IHSA staff. Please recognize Marty for his commitment to high school students in Illinois, as well as an integral role in bringing March Madness to Peoria. Presenting medallions for fourth place will be John Stimler, assisted by Dr. Chuck Nagel. At this time, please meet the Vikings of Geneva, fourth place in 4A with a record of 30-5. The principal, Tom Rogers. Athletic director, Jim Kafer.
Thank you.
Assistant athletic director, Dave Carley. Certified athletic trainer, William Duran. Head coach, Phil Ralston. Assistant coach, Scott Hennig. Assistant coach, Rob Wazinski. Now the Viking players, zero, Daniel Santa Catarina. Four, Pace Temple. Five, Chandler Fusat. 10, Ryan Ralston. 12, Brandon Schleicher. 15, Jack Dreyer. 22, Jake Rocks. 23, Bennett Fusat. 25, Nate Navigato. 30, Sean Chambers. 32, Stephen Moyer. 33, Ben Stahl. 42, Brian Callalee. 52, Mike Landy. Other members of the squad, Zach Samples. Drew Klaus. Jordan Vetter. And Boone DeLavalle. The Vikings of Geneva, 4A, fourth place. Congratulations. Presenting medallions and assisting, Robert Nolting and Gerald Morrow. Please meet the Raiders of Bolingbrook, who finish in third place in 4A, a record of 25-7. Superintendent of Bolingbrook, Dr. James Mitchum. Principal, Yolanda Jordan. Athletic Director, Robert Rose. Certified Athletic Trainer, Maddie Kaminskis. Head Coach, Rob Gross. Assistant Coach, Paul Gamikia. Assistant Coach, Dominic Tapia. Assistant Coach, Bear Timmer. Assistant Coach, Tony Smith. Assistant Coach, Ryan Altenberg. Stats, Art Paul. And now the Raider players. Three, Broderick Thomas. Four, Devin Sams. Five, Prentice Nixon. 10, A.J. Tidwell. 12, Nate Webb. 15, Clifton Smith. 20, Antoine Locke. 22, Lance Phillips. 25, Derek Anderson. 30, Nana Akenton. 33, Rashawn Isom. 35, Julian Torres. 40, Dimitri Akenton. 42, Brandon Lawani. And 50, Zach Grady. Third place, Bolingbrook Raiders, 25-7, 2015. Congratulations. And now presenting the fourth place trophy, Director B. Kent Jones. Will Coach Ralston and the captains of Geneva step forward to receive the fourth place trophy? Presenting third place, Peter Groom. Coach Brost and the captains of Bolingbrook, please step forward to receive the third place trophy. Congratulations to both schools, fans, family, and friends. Great seasons all, and thank you for being a part of Original March Madness.
The first ever championship trophy for Bolingbrook in basketball. 1985, they got to the super section round, the previous furthest advancement for Bolingbrook and for the Vikings. Their first trip downstate in 52 years and their very first trophy in boys basketball. We have a state championship trophy to hand out. Highlights and stats coming up.